War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. Terminal somewhere. Critical fire. Terminal somewhere. giant roaches? What the hell? Here. Where is everyone? Is this all that's left? There we go. Excellent. If I only had a bobby pin.
As I live and breathe, oh, it's really you.
Codsworth? You're still here. So, other people could still be alive too.
But of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little
radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the wife see you in that state, hmm? Where is the missus, by the way?
They killed her.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
He's gone. God damn it. Someone took him. Someone stole my son.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little. For the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house! And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Whoa, whoa. Focus, Codsworth.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome.
Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Sean may turn up yet.
I don't know, Codsworth.
Follow me. What's all this then? Peek-a-boo! Senses are picking up movement in another house. Follow me! Terrific! It's a fight then!
Abby isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
Come on, Codsworth. I need your help. Where can I go?
Well, you could head into the city.
Concord is nearby.
But the people there are as put together as I am.
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station?
I shall remain here and secure the home front.
I need to assign someone to this.
Thank you. see. No, no, no. No fingers away. There we go. Okay. Just see it. Right there. Right there. Yay. Hi, honey. Listen, I don't think that Sean and I need to tell you how great of a father you are. But we're going to anyway. Isn't that right? You are kind and loving. Funny. That's right. And patient. So patient. Patience of a saint, my mom used to say. Look, with Sean and us all being home together, it's been an amazing year. But even so, I know our best days are yet to come. There'll be changes, sure. Things we need to adjust to. You'll rejoin the civilian workforce, and I'll shake the dust off my law degree. But everything we do, no matter how hard, we do it for our family. Now, say goodbye, Sean. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Come on. Bye, honey. We love you.